Why is current affairs so important? 40% of your syllabus in phase 1, 70% of your ESI questions in phase 2, 30% of finance questions in phase 2, and approximately 50% of your English essay is dependent directly on your preparation of current affairs. There are 6 major questions that come to a student's mind when thinking about current affairs for regulatory exams like RBI, SEBI or NABARD. Number 1, what should be the focus when reading or starting with current affairs? Number 2, what you should be reading in current affairs? Number 3, how you should be covering current affairs? Number 4, what not to do, which is all the more important? Number 5, how to make notes in current affairs, which is always very confusing? And number 6, how to revise? Number 5, how to make notes, and number 6, how to revise, the I-cards for them are available above. You can see those videos as well. So I will be covering a total of 4 points today. Let's start with the first one. What should be the focus when covering current affairs? Well, the focus has to be two-dimensional, analytical as well as factual. If you're missing out on any one of these, then it's a recipe for disaster. So whenever you're reading anything related to current affairs, try to understand the concept, the history, the idea behind the current affairs, and also keep in mind that you cannot forget about the factual parts. The second question is what to cover in current affairs. I've divided it into 3 parts: phase 1, phase 2 current affairs, and topic-wise current affairs. Let's start with phase 1 current affairs. I further divided it into multiple parts. The first one is daily videos, which help you simplify a lot of concepts which might be difficult to understand. The second is daily PDFs, which help you make notes. The third one is daily questions or quiz, which helps you practice regularly so that you stay in line with what the examination is demanding. Now, all these 3 things are available on my new current affairs website, and I'll be discussing it very shortly. Coming to the second point, which is phase 2 current affairs. It can be further divided into ESI and RBI current affairs, or ESI and finance current affairs. For ESI current affairs, I come out with a daily magazine or a daily coverage, which is called as PIB 247. For finance, I come out with a daily coverage, which is called as RBI 247. So the videos for these daily coverages are available on YouTube as well as on my current affairs website. The daily PDFs or the weekly PDFs are given only to the enrolled students, but the daily quiz is also available on the new current affairs website, which will help you practice regularly. Okay. The third one is topic-wise current affairs. Now, topic-wise, may you all must be aware there is government schemes, there is indices and reports, there is census, there is economic survey, there is budget, and the list goes on. And I've already talked about those things in detail in my syllabus coverage as well. Now, let me take you through my new current affairs website, which will help you understand how you can cover current affairs for both phase 1 and phase 2 in a more organized, holistic, and a very easy manner.
Hi guys, so here you can see the new website, which is called as currentaffairs.anujindal.in. This is where you can check it out. You can also go to the website through anujindal.in itself, as you can check out the current affairs section there, and you will be taken to this another website called as currentaffairs.anujindal.in. It's a very simple and a very user-friendly website where I'm providing only the current affairs. So how does it work? So there are 3 columns here. The first one is daily news, which is basically phase 1 news, spotlight news. Then you have PIB 247 videos, and then you have RBI 247 videos. Okay. So as you click on 19th May, you will be taken to another page. This is the page where you can read the entire news of 19th May 2021. The topics that have been covered in this entire document are also written here, so you can just Google them directly if you don't want to go to the document, or you can keep it for later as well if you want to cover it later. The video is also available here. Then you have a very crisp summarization of the entire coverage of today, of 19th May. Okay, so you can just go through this as well if you want to, or you can use this to make your notes. The table of content contains all the coverages for today. For example, today on 19th, we've covered national, international awards and quiz. And then you're taken to all the news of national, international awards and quiz. The final is quiz, wherein the quiz of 19th May is available. Now, how do you go to the quiz directly as well? For example, here you can see daily news is covered here. Then the videos of phase 2, that is PIB247 and RBA247, are available here. If you scroll down, you will see here daily quiz of phase 1, and on the right hand side you will see PIB247 quiz and RBA247 quiz. So the right two columns are for phase 2, and the first column is specifically for phase 1. Although there is no such watertight compartmentalization of current affairs, however you can divide it very broadly here. Okay, so if you click on this 19th May quiz, you will be taken to another page. This is the page where the quiz is available. You can just take the quiz, as I'm taking the quiz right now. I'm just randomly marking all the answers. I submit the quiz and I'll be given my score immediately. So the first one, my answer was incorrect and the correct answer was Jharkhand. The second one, my answer of Orissa was incorrect. Correct answer is Telangana. Third one, my answer was Mongolia, which was incorrect. Correct answer is China. Fourth one, my answer was incorrect. Correct answer is both A and B. Fifth one, my answer was incorrect and the correct answer is Karnataka. So this way, I get the answers immediately. Similarly, if I want to take quiz for phase 2, that is PIB247 and RBA247, I can do that as well. So when I click on 17th, 18th May 2021 PIB quiz, I am taken to this place where I have both PIB and RBA quiz available. So I can take these quizzes also in a similar manner. It's very, very easy. I can take whatever quiz I want and I'll be given the answers immediately. Okay. So this kind of quiz taking is always very, very helpful on a regular or daily basis. So please start doing this regularly for your upcoming examination. Okay. Don't miss it out. So these are the things that are available here. One more thing. If you want to have access to the monthly spotlight, that is also available here. So April 2021, March, February and January. All 4 months are available here in the stock at the moment. So you can just click on them and download them. Okay. So this is all about the new website called as currentaffairs.anujindal.in.
The third question that comes to our mind is how to cover current affairs. It's a very simple question with a very simple answer, but made very difficult at a lot of times. इसके क्या क्या हम divisions create करें so that we can understand how to actually cover current affairs. The first thing that we need to keep in mind is there is no time limit to current affairs. If you're a serious aspirant preparing for RBI, SEBI or NABARD examination, start your preparation today of current affairs. ये नहीं सोचना है कि exam से एक महीने पहले या तीन महीने पहले का current affairs cover करना है, or I'll be covering only current affairs of 6 months or a year before the examination. The faster you start with your current affairs, the better it is. Okay. Now the second question is how to cover current affairs when you've already decided that you have to start now. So keep in mind that you have to cover them daily and revise them daily. Now the revision technique I've already discussed in another video. The iCard for that is available above. Make sure that you're covering your current affairs on a daily basis for both phase 1 and phase 2. The third thing to keep in mind is revision made notes. It's very important that whatever notes you're making are revisable towards the end of the exam. I remember I got a call from a UPSC aspirant who asked me, "Sir, I've covered almost everything in my UPSC preparation, but now I'm confused how to consolidate and revise the entire study material because it's so much. I have hundreds of books, literally hundreds of books, from where I have picked up stuff that I liked, but I did not make notes in a revisable format." Fortunately, I've already created a video on how to make notes, and although it might take more time to make notes through that technique, Cornell method, however, it'll make sure that your notes are revisable and you can consolidate and compress your preparation towards the examination. Coming to the last question, but in fact the most important question of all, is what not to do when preparing current affairs. Do cheezon ka dhyan rakhna hai when covering current affairs that you cannot do at any cost. Number one is read newspaper only when you're exhausted in the day. Newspaper should not be the first thing that you read in the day, although I also tend to get back to the newspaper only every day, but try and read it in the evening time. It is always more suitable. It is always more rewarding. The second thing that you have to keep in mind is do not pick up more than 2 sources. For RBI, SEBI and NABARD specifically, I can vouch that my sources are more than enough for the current affairs. But even if you want to be more safe, two sources are the max that you can pick up. If you start picking up sources meant for UPSC, then you're going to confuse yourself and you will end up wasting a lot more time in your current affairs preparation. Remember, the focus should be always to clear the examination and not to get a PhD in the examination. I'm sure this video will help you understand or get a better idea about what to do and what not to do while you're covering current affairs for your regulatory exams preparation like RBI, SEBI and NABARD. All the best guys, take care, bye-bye.